After studying this module, you shall be able to know about the value of triangulation in qualitative research, learn about the different kinds of triangulation, identify the use of triangulation in research, reflect on the issues regarding triangulation and qualitative research, have a critical understanding of triangulation. Triangulation is a strategy where the use of more than one approach is used in the investigation of a research question. It is suggested that this increases the validity of research findings. It helps to overcome the limitation of any method, data source, investigator, or theory, and hence provides a means of creating innovative ways of understanding a phenomena, revealing unique findings, challenging or integrating theories, and providing a clearer understanding of the problem, by Thurmond in 2001. History of the concept of triangulation. Triangulation is a well-known process in trigonometry and geometry. It is used to determine the location of a point by measuring angles to it from two known points of a fixed baseline. Surveyors and sailors are known to use this method for navigation. For example, in the 19th century, precise measurement of large parts of Europe was made first using triangles, which were used then to develop a grid of survey points. In today's modern technology, triangulation is also used extensively. Handheld global positioning systems, GPS, automatically calculate the current position of the GPS using existing knowledge of the locations of satellites at any given time, by Opperman in 2000. In the social sciences, triangulation is a relatively new concept, first introduced by Campbell and Fisk in 1959. This suggested that in order to measure psychological traits, more than one method should be developed such that several traits can be measured simultaneously. The term triangulation was first coined and used by Webb et al. In 1966. In their work on non-reactive measures in the social science. They suggested that once a proposition has been confirmed by two or more independent measurement processes, the uncertainty of its interpretation is greatly reduced. The most persuasive evidence comes through a triangulation of measurement processes. However, it was Denzin, 1978, who provided a detailed discussion on triangulation and explicated the various methods of triangulation in research. Peyton in 1980 emphasizes the important but difficult nature of triangulation. There is no magic in triangulation. The evaluator using different methods to investigate the same program should not expect that the findings generated by those different methods will automatically come together to produce some nicely integrated whole. The point of triangulation, he suggests, is to study and understand when and why there are differences. Smith and Kleene in 1986 suggests that the use of multi-methods result in different images of understanding, thus increasing the potency of evaluation findings. Types of triangulation. Triangulation is the combination of at least two or more theoretical perspectives, methodological approaches, data sources, investigators, or data analysis methods. The intent of using triangulation is to decrease, negate, or counterbalance the deficiency of a single strategy, thereby increasing the ability to interpret the findings, by Thurmond in 2001. Types of triangulation. Data triangulation. Data triangulation, simply understood, refers to collecting data from more than one source. For example, interviewing more than one individual about a road accident they witnessed. However, Denzin in 1970 has extended this notion to include time and space such that data is collected at different times and in various social situations, as well as on the range of people. Other examples of data triangulation are collecting data across seasons or different times of the day, or for example, to collect data from different settings. So if the research is on children's play, to visit parks, schools, playgrounds, etc. Investigator triangulation. Investigator triangulation refers to the use of more than one researcher in the field to gather and interpret data. This is usually considered a good practice and is often already built into the research process because more than one person is needed for data collection. For example, in carrying out a survey across the city of Delhi, to understand the attitudes towards cleanliness and pollution, a significant number of researchers would be required in order to collect data from all over the city. At the same time, the task is also to decide on how many researchers there should be, who they are, and how they would contribute to the process of data collection. By Denzin in 1978, Miles in 1982. The process of data collection and data analysis is often not very clearly separate, and thus who collects how much data are important questions to which there is no clear answer. Each research and researcher will have to come to their own answers, by Matheson in 1988. Methodological triangulation. Methodological triangulation refers to the use of more than one method for gathering data. It is the most often used and discussed form of triangulation. Denzin in 1978 suggests two kinds of approaches, within method and between method. In the within method approach, variation of the same method is used to investigate a research issue. For example, multiple scales are used together to assess a trait like intelligence. Denzin has pointed out the limitation of the within method approach since only one method is being used. In the between methods approach, different research methods such as the survey questionnaires and observation are used together to collect data. Most researchers focus primarily on between methods triangulation. The rationale for this strategy is that the flaws of one method are often the strengths of another. And by combining methods, observers can achieve the best of each while overcoming their unique deficiencies, by Denzin in 1978. For example, in order to understand how the presence of children affects parents' decision making in a supermarket, one could use a combination of observation and survey. Another way in which methodological triangulation is used is by combining qualitative and quantitative methods, also referred to as the mixed methods approach. For example, a researcher may decide to use a structured questionnaire to gather data for statistical analysis of the correlation between drug addiction and domestic violence, and complement it with focus group discussions with drug abusers and victims of domestic violence. Theoretical triangulation. Theoretical triangulation refers to the use of more than one theoretical position in interpreting data. For example, triangulation of theory may occur in considering a number of concepts from anthropology, sociology, and psychology in the interpretation of the experience of mourning. Advantages and disadvantages of triangulation. Advantages of triangulation. The value of triangulation is the variety and quantity of data that is gathered and can be used for analysis. The method has several advantages, which are as follows. It uses more than one method or paradigm and hence increases the confidence in results. It strengthens the completeness of the study by providing a holistic picture, and many researchers believe it can result in data that is richer, more complex and authentic, by Foss and Ilson in 2002. It enables one to address questions that are dissimilar in nature but nevertheless complementary in one study itself. It enhances interpretability as one set of data also helps in understanding the other set of data. It requires the researcher to be deeply involved in the research situation and hence leads to a more nuanced understanding of the focus of the study. It enhances the validity of the research, by Bradley in 1995. In using different methods together, the researcher benefits from the uniqueness of each method, and at the same time, using contrasting methods increases the chances of overcoming the limitation of any one method. Disadvantages of triangulation. Triangulation also has several limitations. The data collection has to be planned thoroughly and organized effectively. The resources that may be required are often not available or easily accessible. Researchers may not be technically competent in particular methods. It is possible that the various research paradigm used are not compatible by Duffy in 1985, Blake in 1991, Simon Sharp in 1998. Many researchers are not clear in how triangulation has been used and how it has added value to their research by Oberst in 1993. Undertaking replication and comparative studies may be difficult. Researchers might be tempted to make inconsistent data sets artificially compatible in order to produce a more coherent account. Some other disadvantages include the possibly disharmony based on the investigator biases, conflicts because of the theoretical frameworks, and lack of understanding about why triangulation strategies were used by Thurmond in 2001. Overcoming limitation. Several strategies have been suggested by various researchers in order to limit the effects of the disadvantages that have been mentioned. These are: the research question should be well formulated and precise by Michel in 1986, Dutzen in 1995, and Begley in 1996. Clarity in how the research is making use of triangulation by Miles and Hoberman in 1984, Shi in 1998, and why it is being used. Researchers Denzin and Morse, Johnson et al. Have emphasized that the fact that each data collection method should be applied in a disciplined manner following the protocols and should be complete in itself. The researchers should be able to state how triangulation helped in making the research more valid, credible, or complete. Some issues surrounding triangulation. Assumption of cancelling bias. The idea of triangulation as a research strategy is based on two assumptions. The first is that using more than one data source, method, investigator, or theory would minimize bias, or that the bias inherent in any one method would be cancelled by the other methods that are used in combination. This assumption often goes unexamined, but some researchers, Mathinson in 1988, have criticized on the basis that different methods produced different understandings of the same phenomena, and they might be tapping different aspects of knowledge. Scriven in 1972 distinguishes between the meaning of objectivity in the qualitative and quantitative research paradigm. By Mathinson in 1988, under the quantitative research paradigm, one individual's view is considered to be subjective and the collective view of the many individual is taken to be objective. In the qualitative research paradigm, objectivity points to the observation being factual, while being subjective means that the observation has some bias in it. The quantitative notion of objectivity seems to underlie discussions of triangulation at the expense of the quantitative notions of objectivity. It is assumed then that like the view of one person is biased and hence subjective, if we use only one method, it will be necessarily subjective and hence biased. Triangulation is the methodological counterpart to intersubjective agreement, and just as with individuals, reliability is confused with validity, by Mathison in 1988. Assumption of reality or one truth. The second assumption related to the first is that there is one social reality or truth that we are trying to reach, and that through the use of triangulation, there would be a convergence upon the truth about a social phenomena. The realist notion of there being a single definitive account of the social world has been criticized, especially by the followers of social constructionism, who argue that social reality is not created or discovered by any individual, but that meanings are generated in corroboration with the other individuals. Thus, research findings are not truths, but one among the many possible accounts of social phenomena. However, social constructionists do not consider triangulation to be a redundant research strategy. They believe that it leads to a more complex and richer account of social reality and hence is useful. Following the argument, it has been suggested that there are three possible outcomes of triangulation. These are: convergence, refers to the outcome that data from different sources, methods, or investigators will provide data that will act as evidence in support of a single premise about social phenomena. Inconsistency refers to the outcome when multiple sources, methods, or investigators are used and the evidence suggests more than one perspectives, or the information collected does not confirm one single idea about a social phenomena and presents alternatives that are inconsistent with each other and have ambiguities. Contradiction refers to the possible outcome where not only data is found to be inconsistent, but it suggests opposing views. The value of triangulation is not as a solution to the data collection and the problem of analysis. It is a technique which provides more and better evidence from which researcher can construct meaningful propositions about the social world. Inconsistent and contradictory data adds complexity and depth to our understanding and has as much, if not more, value in relation to convergent data. Addressing the question of validity in qualitative research. The question of validity is an important one in the qualitative research. When qualitative research refer to validity, they are usually referring to research that is plausible, credible, trustworthy, and hence defensible. Several strategies have been developed to address the question of validity in qualitative research. Summary: triangulation is a relatively new concept in research and has its roots in concepts of triangulation used in trigonometry and geometry. There are four kinds of triangulation that are possible in any research design. These are data triangulation, methodological triangulation, investigator triangulation, and theoretical triangulation. Of these, the most commonly used is methodological triangulation, where two or more methods are used to collect data or to analyze the results. The concept of triangulation, especially methodological triangulation, has come under attack from several researchers. It has been suggested that often the different methods used do not come together and can thus there needs to be clear understanding of the methods being used as well as having a well-formulated rationale for using several methods. In general, the assumption that triangulation reduces or cancels out bias present in the research, as well as the assumption that the point of using triangulation is to reach a convergence upon the truth of a social phenomena, have been questioned, and there is no clear evidence in support of either assumption. The question of validity, however, remains a crucial one in qualitative research.